Welcome to the second video of Unit 1, One-Dimensional Motion. In this video, we're going to discuss how to find the distance and displacement by looking at a position-time graph. You may have seen position-time graphs in your physics or math class, but if you're new to this, a position-time graph tells you an object's position at a specific moment in time. Position-time graphs help us solve problems regarding an object's distance traveled and displacement. And I don't think I covered this in the previous video, but we denote position with x, and we usually measure our time in seconds. Now let's get into an example. So here we have a position-time graph of a sheep, and we're asked what is the sheep's distance traveled in 10 seconds, and what's the sheep's displacement in 10 seconds. Let us solve for our distance first. Remember, in the previous video, we defined distance as a total length an object has traveled. So we see here that from 0 to 2 seconds, our sheep changes position from 0 to 8. That's a total of 8 meters our sheep has traveled. From 2 to 6 seconds, our sheep remained at its position of 8. So the total distance our sheep traveled is 0 meters. So from 6 to 8 seconds, our sheep changes position from 8 to 4. So the total distance our sheep traveled is 4 meters. Lastly, from 8 to 10 seconds, our sheep remained at the position of 4. So our total distance our sheep traveled is 0 meters. So now let's add all these values together. We have 8 meters plus 0 meters plus 4 meters plus 0 meters. This will give us a total of 12 meters for our distance. Now, let's solve for our displacement. Remember, displacement is defined as a change in position of an object. We take into account the magnitude as well as the direction. So from 0 to 2 seconds, our sheep traveled from 0 to 8. So that's a positive 8 meters for our displacement. From 2 to 6 seconds, our sheep remained at the position of 8. So our displacement is 0 meters. From 6 to 8 seconds, our sheep changes position from 8 to 4. And since we're taking into account the direction the sheep traveled, our displacement is 4 meters. Lastly, from 8 to 10 seconds, our sheep remain at the position of 4. So our sheep's displacement is 0 meters. Now let's add all these values together. So you have positive 8 meters plus 0 meters minus 4 meters plus 0 meters, giving us a total of 4 meters for our displacement. Now, another way we can solve is using the formula delta x equals our final position minus our initial position. So we know that our final position is here at 4. And we know that our initial position is here at 0. So let's plug these values in. And this will give us a total of 4 meters. So either method works. Okay, this problem may look similar to the last, but take caution because this time I'm asking you what's the sheep's distance traveled in 6 seconds and what's the sheep's displacement in 6 seconds. So like we did last time, let's solve our distance first. So from 0 to 2 seconds, our sheep traveled from the position of 0 to 8. So that's a total distance of 8 meters. From 2 to 6 seconds, our sheep remained at a position of 8. So our total distance traveled is 0 meters. Now let's add these two values together. So we have 8 meters plus 0 meters, giving us a total of 8 meters for our distance traveled in 6 seconds. Now let's solve for our displacement. So from 0 to 2 seconds, our sheep traveled 0 to 8. So that's a positive 8 meters for our displacement. From 2 to 6 seconds, our sheep remained at 8. So the total displacement is 0 meters. Now let's add those two values together. So you have 8 meters, positive 8 meters, plus 0 meters, giving us a total of 8 meters for a displacement in 6 seconds. Now, we can also use a formula to solve. Delta x equals our final position minus our initial position. So we know that our final position is here at 8. And we know that our initial position is here at 0. So we just plug in these two values into our formula to get our displacement. So we have 8 meters minus 0 meters, giving us a total of 8 meters for our displacement. Okay, let's look at one last example. This time we're asked, what's a sheep's distance traveled in 8 seconds, and what's the sheep's displacement in 8 seconds? So from 0 to 1 second, our sheep traveled 4 meters, because remember, we only take into account the magnitude of which it traveled. From 1 to 3 seconds, our sheep traveled 2 meters. From 3 to 5 seconds, our sheep traveled 0 meters because it remained at negative 2. From 5 to 8 seconds, our sheep traveled 12 meters because we went from negative 2 to 0, that's 2 meters, and then 0 to 10, which is 10 meters, so 2 plus 10 is 12 meters. So now let's add all our values together. So that's 4 meters plus 2 meters plus 0 meters plus 12 meters. This will give us a total of 18 meters for our distance traveled in 8 seconds. Okay, now let's solve for our displacement. From 0 to 1 second, our sheep was displaced negative 4 meters. Because remember, when we're dealing with displacement, we have to take into account the direction our object has traveled. From 1 to 3 seconds, our sheep was displaced positive 2 meters. From 3 to 5 seconds, our sheep was displaced 0 meters because it remained at negative 2. And from 5 to 8 seconds, our sheep was displaced positive 12 meters. So now let's add all those values together. So we have negative 4 meters plus 2 meters plus 0 meters plus 12 meters. This will give us a total of 10 meters for our displacement. And yes, we can use the formula. We have delta x equals our final position minus our initial position. So our final position was here at 10 meters. And our initial position was here at 0. So let's plug in these values. So we have 10 meters minus 0 meters, giving us our displacement of 10 meters. So in recap, position time graphs help us solve for an object's distance and displacement. Thank you for watching the video, and hope to see you next time.